gevoer met Dinsdag Perspektief. Donderdag is Internationale Moedertaaldag. En ons gesels met Karin Brits van die ATKV en Themba Madingiza. Hy is 'n docent aan die Departement Afrika Tale by die Universiteit van Johannesburg. Baie welkom. Welkom in de studio. Julle, hoekom is waar daar so, ek meen, hier is nou Internationale Moedertaaldag, nee? Hoekom word daar so 'n groot gewag gemaak van moedertaal? Why the big hoo-ha about mother language, mother tongue? Themba, I think you start for us.
Yes, this is a very important day because it's a day where you celebrate your mother tongue language, which also identifies you. It lets the people know who you are, where you're from, what's the culture. So it's also about going back to your roots, retaining who you are, not forgetting what has made who you are today. So it's going back to the roots, remembering your language and your culture.
But the thing is, I'm sure people are very confused because yes. So many people do not grow up in their mother tongue anymore. I mean, people like to send their kids to an English school. I mean, I don't know, but Afrikaans people, a lot of Afrikaans people. So wat gebeur dan in terme van daai wortels en kultuur?
Ja, ek wil aansluit, dit is deel van ons identiteit. Ons kan nie die taal wegredeneer nie. Maar buiten die identiteit gaan dit ook oor my akademiese prestasie. En dit is die groot rede hoekom Moedertaaldag eintlik gevier word. En ons doen eintlik ons kinders 'n baie groot onreg aan om hulle nie in 'n moedertaal te laat skool gaan nie. Want wat doen jy? Jy konseptualiseer in jou moedertaal. Jy dink in jou moedertaal. As ek nou in Engels moet skool gaan, moet ek nou eers in Engels dink voordat ek konseptualiseer. So dit is 'n langer proses om my kennis te verwerf.
Maar baie Afrikaanse kinders stuur tog hulle kinders na Engelse skool toe. Many Afrikaans people send their kids to an English school. I'm sure many.
Yeah.
And those kids do well at school. I mean, it's not that they at home, they don't even speak their mother tongue at home. They don't even speak Zulu or Xhosa or Afrikaans at home anymore. They speak English becomes their mother tongue.
Yes, that's the challenge we're having. And having a day like this, we're trying to preserve, you know, these languages, you know, because if we do nothing about them, they'll end up being like dinosaurs, you know, they'll be non-existent, and your identity will be erased. So I know that in schools, yes, most subjects are done in English, but with this day, we're trying to let parents to remember that at home, when your child comes back from school, they should engage with them in their own African language, because, you know, it tells them more about themselves, their history, yeah, who they are. So it's all about preserving, yeah, your identity.
But it's also
ek wil nou ook sê, ons dink nou aan die mense om ons wat na Afrikaans is, wat hulle kinders na Engelse skole toe stuur, maar dit is gewoonlik ook mense wat die geld het. En die geleenthede vir daardie kind kan gee wat hulle blootstel aan Engels, maar wat word van die mense wat nie daai geleenthede het nie. En my bekommernis lê by daai mense, die kinders wat nie van graad 1 tot matriek gaan nie, as gevolg van nie moedertaalonderrig. En ons vergeet van hulle, ongelukkig.
En wat word van hulle?
Wat word van hulle en wat word, hoe raak het ons ekonomie? Môre hoor ons, luister ons na die begrotingsrede. Maar praat ons daaroor, oor die miljoene wat ons verloor as gevolg van kinders wat nie matriek klaar maak nie. Ons kyk altyd na die matriekuitslae, dis wonderlik. Maar kyk ons ooit na die kinders wat dit nie deur die stelsel gemaak het nie.
Ja, maar dink jy dit is kinders wat, dink jy dis omdat hulle dit nie in hulle moedertaal doen nie?
Ek dink dit speel baie groot rol.
So, in South Africa it's a sensitive matter. I mean, yes. If we're only thinking, you know, I can only speak for Afrikaans of course, because of the history of Afrikaans.
Yes.
And it's also very, it's almost divisive in a way. Mother tongue language. Do you agree or don't you feel like that?
Yeah, you know, it's quite a tricky one because yeah, you also mentioned Afrikaans, which we see at the moment that with higher education, students are protesting against the usage of the language, which with me, I ask myself, if they're fighting against Afrikaans, what are they saying about African languages? Why shouldn't they rather be focusing on the promotion of African languages? Because if you look at Afrikaans, black Africans, most of them, they do speak the language indirectly. Most borrowed words are from Afrikaans. So in a way, Afrikaans, it is part of our African languages. So on this day, what we also promote is that we want people to be multilingual. Don't only recognize your own language, but also other languages spoken in South Africa.
Because isn't that the problem, that other languages are not really recognized? Because we're pushing, Afrikaans people are pushing Afrikaans. So we forget about there are also 11, or no, 9 other languages.
Yeah.
And for example, do Zulu people feel as strongly about their language as Afrikaans speakers feel?
Yeah, what you would get is that language goes with culture. So you would find that people would want to fight for their language, fight for their culture. But my view is that language should be seen as a tool to send the message across. It doesn't matter what language is it. The most important thing is that we both understand the language and the message is sent across. As we use English, when I speak English, I don't follow the English culture the way they live, but I'm using the language to send the message across. The same can be done with Afrikaans or isiZulu, just to send the message.
So wat sou jy byvoorbeeld sê vir mense? Want die mense, Afrikaanse mense kan nogal dikwels daarop aandring, ek wil in Afrikaans gehelp word en so aan. Jy weet, hoe moet 'n mens jou taal uit lewe sonder om dit onaangenaam te maak vir ander mense?
Ja, ek dink mens moet erkenning gee aan die rol wat Afrikaans gespeel het in 76. Mens moet nou nie jou soos 'n volstruis na jou kop in die sand gaan steek nie. Maar dit nie daar bly nie. Ons moet dit ook gebruik om 'n brug te bou. En ek dink mense moet Afrikaans vriendelik gebruik. En Afrikaans sprekendes moet ook nog maar bietjie moeite doen om 'n Afrika taal aan te leer. Daar onmiddellike ander reaksie as ek in Tswana met iemand praat en ek kry 'n antwoord in Afrikaans terug. Ek dink nie ons moet die hele tyd sê ja, praat net Afrikaans nie. Doen 'n bietjie moeite en reik uit na die mense wat langs jou bly.
En is dit hoe mense dit meer inklusief sal maak? Jy weet wat jy almal sal insluit. Daai manier. Ek praat 'n bietjie van jou taal, jy praat 'n bietjie van my taal. Dis okay as jy jou taal praat, is okay as ek my taal praat.
Ek dink ons het nou geluister na wat in die natuurlewe gebeur. En ek dink Afrikaans of tale kan vergelyk word met biodiversiteit. Wat gebeur as ons biodiversiteit verdwyn? Dan is ons op 'n afdraande pad. En dis dieselfde met taaldiversiteit. Ons groei juis omdat ons ander tale om ons het wat gepraat word. Soos wat ons biodiversiteit nodig het, ons ook taaldiversiteit nodig. En dit is die manier waarop ons vir mekaar ruimte in hierdie taallandskap gee.
And it actually enriches our country, our people, that we have so many different languages.
Of course.
So what do you think can we do to respect one another's language? How can we keep it inclusive? What can we do?
Well, it's all about starting to learn another person's language, you know, starting with the greeting, how would they like to be addressed, you know, tell me about your name, if it's an African name, what does it mean, you know, how you got the name. So it's all about trying to learn the basic words, you know, for conversations, which would interact with the other person. It's about, let's say, in the office, and there's the cleaner which gets into your office and collects dirt every time. You would greet her, try to greet her, you know, let's say isiZulu if it's her mother tongue, and you know that would bring sort of like in the same level. So we would be doing away with that you are in high in the office, you are up there, and she's down there as a cleaner. Mm-hmm. The language brings you together at the same level. So it's about learning those few words, you know, expressions, in other languages.
Sulke partytjies hou waar mense by mekaar kom en kan leer. Maar julle werk albei in 'n omgewing waar julle moedertaal kan praat. So dit is tog tot 'n sekere mate is 'n voordeel met Engels wat so half die voertaal word in die meeste maatskappye.
Ja, dit is so lekker om met sy eie taal te kan werk. Yeah. Dit is soveel vinniger om 'n e-pos te tik. Wat mens nou in 'n ander taal moet ek meteen eers weer gedink, is dit nou enkelvoud, meervoud? Dalk het dit vinnig doen. En dit is net gewoon lekker om in jou eie taal jou emosies te kan deel met jou kollegas.
Okay. Julle baie dankie. Dit is lekker om julle hier te hê. Dankie vir die inkom. Dit is Karin Brits en Themba Medingisa. En baie dankie dat jy by die huis saam gekyk het. Dit is Perspektief vir die week. Ons sien vir jou weer volgende Sondag aand vir 'n diepte bespreking van al die week se nuus gebeure. Totsiens.